Hello guys, this is Revan from Digi Integrity. Welcome to Tech News episode 82.
Battlegrounds Mobile India may not let players transfer their inventory from PUBG Mobile. Krafton has officially announced a comment on this matter. Battlegrounds Mobile India pre-registration start on May 18th in India. Bharti Airtel, India's premier communication solution provider, today announced a special benefit for low-income customers on its networks to help them stay connected during the ongoing pandemic. As a one-time gesture, Airtel will give a 49 rupees pack free to cost of over 55 million low-income customers. The pack offers a talk time of 38 rupees and 100 MB data with a validity of 28 days. Though this gesture, Airtel will empower over 55 million customers, mostly in rural areas, to stay connected and them have access to critical information when needed. At this time, customers have an increased requirement of stay connected. Keeping this in mind, Airtel prepaid customers buying the package of rupees 79 recharge coupon will now be get the double of benefit. This will make it easier for them to stay connected at a difficult time. These benefits will be available to Airtel customers in the coming week. Mobile messaging service WhatsApp told the Delhi High Court on Monday that it has not been deferred the May 15 deadline for users to accept its new privacy policy. The social media intermediary told the court, though its lawyer Kapil Sibal, that it is trying to get users on board, but in case they don't agree, their accounts will be slowly be deleted. The company has pushed back the deadline for its continuous new privacy policy launch in January this year. The updated policy will allow WhatsApp to share some data about users' interaction with the business accounts with its parent company Facebook. Twitter is considering launching a paid subscription service called Twitter Blue, according to unreleased feature of the app discovered by an independent researcher. Jane Machin-Hung, who has made a name for herself through uncovering accidentally public upcoming feature of popular app, shared screenshot of the service, which is paid at $2.99 a month. The National Electronic Fund Transfer for fund transfers will not be available for 14 hours on May 23rd, the Reserve Bank of India has said. The technical upgrade of NEFT, target to enhance the performance and resilience, is scheduled after the close of business of May 22, 2021. Accordingly, NEFT service will not be available from 1 a.m. to 2 p.m. on Sunday, May 23, 2021. The RTGS system will continue to be operational as usual during this period. Squinting at garbled text, trying to make sense of small things in square boxes, or simply clicking on a checkbox to confirm you are a human, not a bot. CAPTCHA is a part and parcel of our daily internet browsing experience. The purpose of CAPTCHA, completely automated public turning challenges, is to boost the security of online services, but the annoying verification process is something most of us would love to do away with. Now, the recent study of web infrastructure and security company Cloudflare has shown that people around the world waste 500 human years every single day while trying to prove that they are not spam bots. This study stated that an average user spends 32 seconds to complete a CAPTCHA challenge and estimated the time by doing a simple math for 4.6 billion global internet users. In a blog post, Cloudflare says its idea is simple. A real human being should be able to touch or look at their device to prove they are human without revealing their identity. The PlayStation 5 pre-order went live at 12 p.m. in India yesterday. The stock was sold out in just seconds after it was available for purchase online. The PS5 units were available on Flipkart, Amazon, and via the official Sony Center online shop. Sharp has announced the Aquos R6 smartphone for the Japanese market. A flagship with only one functional camera on the back, but one that comes with a huge 1-inch sensor. It is the biggest camera sensor put in mobile phone ever, and it was developed jointly with Leica all the way from R&D through lens design to image quality adjustment. This phone comes with a world first Pro EXO OLED 6.67 inch screen that allows for a dynamic refresh rate between 1Hz and 240Hz for finding the perfect balance between power saving and smoothness. Realme already unveiled its Watch 2 in Malaysia last month, and now it seems that we are in for a Pro version. Realme Watch 2 Pro is teased for May 20th launch alongside a series of other smart wearables including Realme Buds Wireless 2, Buds Wireless 2 Neo, and a Realme Pocket Bluetooth speaker. Realme Tech Live, the division of smart gadgets, will soon introduce a new brand. The company and its CEO Madhav Seth teased that it starts with a letter D. However, it is not quite clear if this will be a own brand or its companies that has joined the Tech Live platform. Either way, the new brand will have its own product line. The full announcement will be scheduled for May 25th, Tuesday next week. But we will probably see few more teasers until then. Xiaomi Redmi launched its first ever gaming-focused smartphone, Redmi K40 Game Enhanced Edition, released on last month in China. Now, it seems like Redmi will soon launch a cheaper variant of the Redmi K40 Game Enhanced Edition. Redmi spokesperson Liu Weibing took it to Weibo to tease the upcoming smartphone and revealed that the smartphone will be called as Redmi K40 Lite Luxury Edition. The upcoming Redmi K40 Lite Luxury Edition is expected to launch soon in China. Xiaomi has patented a modular smartphone featuring a zoom camera module. The device houses a periscopic zoom camera and adopts a full-screen design. The Dutch social enterprise company Fairphone uses replaceable modules as well as, however, it uses replaceable modules for different purposes. Making smartphone modular enables manufacturer to effortlessly replace just one part you would need to replace the entire phone if it is not modular. This also helps to minimize the electronic waste. Back in February, it was revealed that the successor to the OnePlus mid-range phone, the Node N10 5G smartphone, will be launched as a Node N1 5G. The source has posted another leak that says that phone will go by a different name, Node CE 5G. According to a tweet by Max Jamber, the Node CE 5G is the name of the smartphone that will be succeed the Node N10 5G. Apparently, OnePlus decided to do last-minute name changes. IQ seems to be expanding its smartphone lineup in the home country China with the launch of a new phone called the IQ Neo Find Vitality Edition. Earlier today, the company also confirmed the launch of the upcoming smartphone on May 24, 2021. The upcoming special edition handset is set to arrive with highlighted features like 44-watt fast charging support and a Snapdragon 870 chipset and a lot more. If you have been waiting for Lenovo to announce its new tablets, then there is a good news. The tablets which we are expected to launch at an event last month but didn't now have an official launch date. An official poster released by the manufacturer has revealed that it will have a launch event on May 25th in China, and from the image, we are pretty sure that it will announce its new tablets on that day. It also appears that we will be getting a new Legion gaming laptop too. Lenovo is expected to launch the Xeoxin Pad Pro 2021, a flagship tablet powered by Snapdragon 870 processor. The Xeoxin Pad Plus, a mid-range tablet with a Snapdragon 750G processor under its hood. And a Yoga Pad Pro, a tablet that can be used as a secondary display for a connected device. Ahead of the Week Society for Information Display exhibition, Samsung Display teased several of its upcoming foldable OLED panel. We get a sneak peek at the brand S foldable panel as well as a slidable option and a large screen panel for laptops with a built-in camera under the panel. The conference will span from today until May 21st. The S foldable screen folds at two points, giving you the flexibility to adjust the design screen real estate on the flight depending on the task at hand. The screen diagonal expands up to 7.2 inches when fully open, but there's also a more manageable form factor with just one fold. The front-facing cameras are housed in the left-hand side bezel of the display. Samsung has joined forces with Hyundai Motor Corporation to collaborate with the South Korean government and some agencies to tackle headlong the global chip shortage. The agreement recently signed by both the companies and the Korean Electronic Technology Institute, the Korean Automotive Technology Institute, and the Ministry of Trade, Industry and Energy will foster a more robust local supply chain for vital semiconductors needed for many production processes within the country. Google I/O is on the horizon, and with the scheduled publish already, there is a lot that we expect to see at the event. It kicks off on May 18th through the May 20th in the form of a virtual event that anyone can attend. And the big one that many of us will be looking forward to, its launch of Android 12. We have gotten through a number of developer preview already, but a last minute Android 12 leak from a John Prosser on Front Page Tech has shown off some new Google widgets and animation ahead of the company's upcoming event. Rockstar Games is yet to announce a sequel to the non-inseparable GTA 5, but their discussion is going on about GTA 6 could bring to the table. Rumors have been long afloat of Grand Theft Auto 6 going back to the Vice City for almost 2 decades. Although in a modern and up-to-date version of the same, a new recent tip now hints at the size and enormity of the game's map. A new map has emerged on the internet that claims to represent GTA 6 Vice City. An earlier version of this map has been circulated with minimum details, but the new one comes with a scale and more details. When comparing to Los Santos, the map is only slightly smaller but has almost similar features, including 2 islands.
Thanks for watching this video. Please kindly support my channel by giving a like, share and subscribe. And follow Digi Integrity on Twitter, Instagram and Facebook.